Huh. Do we get some kind of prize for it, drawing three Nissas? I'm going to keep this because I'm on the play. I have a turn two Grimflayer and a removal spell, meaning that the Grimflayer will help me find more threats. That is a puzzle knot. Okay. Always feels great when you can just connect on the Grimflayer here. I mean, I do want to give myself Delirium as quickly as possible, but I'm also interested in drawing that, so. Put in graveyard. My opponent's just going to play Marvel turn four. Oh, man. No lands off the Grimflayer kind of sucks. Yeah, or Planeswalker. Oh, you know what I could have done? Ugh. Can't do it anymore. All right, well. We are playing that game. Here it is, folks. You gonna wait? Okay. Let's get a whiff. Wait. Did my opponent like 100% miss? Wow. That's crazy. There's a land we can put in the graveyard. Let me think. Yeah, the question again is, do I want any of these cards? 3, 4, 5. Let's see, do I have lethal? Let's see, 4, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. Okay. All right, well, if my opponent, like, even if my opponent marvels, it's not enough. Ah. That would do it, though. Ten, 12. So my opponent can go up to 23. Let me think here. So I can play a walking ballista And then minus Nissa. Or, let's see, I can crack a clue and minus... Well, you know what? I mean, to get in for the most amount of damage, I can just minus Nissa twice. So if I minus Nissa twice, that's 10, 12, plus 4 is 16, plus 4 is 20. My opponent goes to 23. Has to deal with both of these threats. And then they die. Okay. I like the part where they die, so... And if they censor this, then they're not going to have the mana to marvel me next turn. So this is lethal. They're at 3. All right. Here comes Marvel. Or not. We did it. We did it. All right, so don't really care about Fatal Push. The center's deliverance is good. I mean, I imagine all the kind of slow cards are good. I don't really want that. The question is, do I want something like Never to Return? So like, just initially, I want all of these cards. And then I gotta cut 9 cards, so. What are they gonna bring in? Well, they're gonna bring in trackers and stuff too, probably, to try to grind you. So I guess all the Never to Returns are fine. They're not absurd, but again, it's just a way to deal with those creatures. Certainly certainly don't want to get rid of Dissenter's Deliverance. Kalitas seems underwhelming. The Walking Ballista can do some work against some of the grindier creatures. Maybe we can shave one of these. Yeah, I mean, by doing this, though, it, like, kind of makes my Winding Constrictors, like, really, really bad. I don't know if that's, like, fine. Like, can we win by playing this strategy where we're just, like, this mid-range Delirium deck without any of this? And instead, we're just trying to, like, you know, we have Delirium creatures, we have Tireless Trackers, and, like, is that a good enough strategy, or is this just taking out too many threats? Alright, I think I want to do this. Oh! This always happens when I'm trying to figure things out. Whatever, we got 2 Dissenter's Deliverances. This hand is great. Okay, see, that was a good draw. Although Rogue Refiner would be kind of annoying. Oh, it's a Virtuoso, also annoying. Well, I need to find lands. Let's cycle. Okay. And play this for 1. Now we can attack with Grimflare. Okay. damage to our opponent. Okay. Just want lands. Question is, do we want the tracker? And put this in the graveyard. No, I don't want the tracker. I can get it back with the Liliana too. Hey, look, turn four Marvel. Man. This is the world we live in, folks. Oh, hey. The thing is, we're not putting that much pressure on our opponent, but look, we can't be too sad. Okay. I actually don't want any of these cards. Sure, the land lets us play Gearhulk, but if it was an untapped land, I think I would have gone for it. But not a tap land there. Man. I just want an untapped land. Is that too much to ask? If I drew an untapped land, I could have gone like Ballista plus this. Does my opponent have another marble? Nope. Yeah, that might be good enough. Oh, man. Again, I don't want to play this because it's like not the most mana efficient play. I can't opt to play a Nissa here. Okay. I mean, yeah, my opponents bought themselves so much time here. Yeah, perhaps the Never to Returns are just not where I want to be. Maybe I just want hand disruption and threats and just attack through everything. Yeah, here's a Marvel. I mean, at this point, we have to get really lucky. Like, my opponent should find an Ulamog at this point. Unless their hand is just like three Ulamogs. Yeah. All right. This time, how about we board these cards in? Let's get aggressive-ish. Okay. Still need to cut three cards. Okay, not a bad start here. Perhaps Gonti is like a little too mid-rangey, like maybe it's just a little too slow. That I'm not sure on. plays around sensor. Okay, sure. Some kind of good 3-mana creature here. Yeah. Give me a hand disruption spell. So this is a glimmer. Huh. I imagine this is a glimmer. Ooh, negate. Interesting. I suppose I could have led off with transgress, then attacked, then maybe I could have gotten it. Yeah, maybe I might have missed that on 1 point of damage there because I could have cracked earlier. The reason why I didn't crack after I attacked is I was kind of concerned about sensor. I'm gonna crack. If you have another Harness Lightning, you have another Harness Lightning. Okay. All right. What do I want to do? I can't imagine them having too many negates post-board, so... The works marvel. Boom! Out of my face. Alright, how did they win? Ooh, look at this. Fancy Torrential Gear Hulk. Kozak's Return. Oh wow, they brought in 3 negates. Ulamogs. Okay, I mean things are looking much better. They have 2 Glimmers and a Rogue Refiner still, so... Alright, let's just go ahead and cycle now to find a land. And then I'm gonna sack this while my opponent can't like Harness Lightning me or whatever. And now I can actually just cycle the Deliverances because they only really have the 1 green Gear Hulk in their deck. So, doing a good job of grinding. And now my opponent is just making Thopters, which makes sense because, you know, this is their only energy sink after sideboard. Here comes a Rogue Refiner. Okay. Sure. Gain 3 life, make a Thopter. Okay. One, two, three. play out the Winding Constrictor here and attack with Tireless Tracker. So yeah, my opponent can make a Thopter here. I can pump the Ballista to start like getting the Thopters, and I think I'm going to. This is looking very good for us. Unless this is a Harness Lightning. And even if it is, I mean, we can still go like Gonti Nissa minus or something like that. And we still have three clues. Main phase Glimmer. Yeah, my opponent really needs to find a Harness Lightning here. Bottom, bottom. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. We do want to put a lot of pressure here because once my opponent can still just hard cast Ulamog, and we definitely don't want that to happen. And it looks like they did find a Harness Lightning. Interesting. Okay, let's see. Yeah, Gonti. Whoo! Wait, why? Do we have artifacts? Oh, we have Walking Ballista. Harness Lightning or Torrential Gear Hulk? I'm gonna go with Harness Lightning. So I can Harness Lightning the Virtuoso. Then make a Thopter. Then we can attack with both. My opponent chumps. Play Grimflayer. Okay. All right, so 3, 4, 5. Okay, I mean my opponent's gaining a bunch of life. They might stable. They might survive to cast Ulamog. It's definitely possible. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, they need to have a shrine here actually, in order for this to be good enough. Let me think. Do I have? I'm just trying to see if I have lethal. I can activate Hissing Quagmire, or I can just play double Nissa and minus twice. And that means that's plus four to my entire team. So my opponent like chump, chump, take 8 plus 4, that's 12. 3, 4, 5, okay, so I can crack a clue first. All right, we got there. Dispossessed, doing some work.